Zen and the Martial Arts. Gonna do a book review today on this. So, Zen and the Martial Arts, this book by Joe Himes, it was written, it was published in 1979. So, what's that, 42 years ago, 42 years ago, I guess. So, it's kind of an older book. I first read it. I got it in, I guess it was 1983 by the suggestion of my first martial arts instructor. So I first read it 38 years ago, and it was the first martial arts book that I had ever got. And yeah, I really liked it a lot. I read it many times over and over. And you can kind of see, I don't know if you can see, but the copy's pretty worn. It was really white and it's pretty wore out. And, you know, this has been, I had to tape it years ago. So I read the stories in this many times. So I enjoyed this book. And it was a great first book to read, especially when I was younger. So it's called Zen in the Martial Arts. Now, Zen is a form of Buddhism, but this book isn't really religious. It's really a collection of short stories of mostly of the experiences of the author Joe Himes, and the stories are small. They're short. They're maybe like 2 to 5 pages, I'd say. It also has interspersed with those stories a bunch of sayings, martial arts sayings, and things like that. And it's the majority of the stories are collections of the people that Joe Himes trained with. And Joe Himes wasn't a martial artist first. He was, involved in other things, but he trained with a lot of influential martial artists, namely like Bruce Lee and Ed Parker, the founder of American Kenpo. Jim Lao, Wing Chun instructor, Bong So Han, the famous Hapkido instructor. So he trained with a lot of famous people. And it's kind of stories that about those people that he trained with and a few others also. Some of the stories in there, one's called Empty Your Cup, and it's a discussion with Bruce Lee he had about how you have to be empty, you know, in order to learn new knowledge, you have to empty your mind of old knowledge so that you can accept something new or old concepts so you can hear something new. I carried that lesson with me from way back in the 80s. There's another one in there called Even the Masters Have Masters. So even as much as you think your instructor is better than you or you know, they've had more experiences. A lot of times they look up to their instructors in the same way. So there's always this continuum of growth, you know, and even the masters have masters. There's one in there called Lengthen Your Line, where he asks someone, what you can do if your opponent's line is, you know, longer than yours. You know, like their skill level or whatever. And, you know, some of the answers were, cut the line up. But I forget who was in that story, if it was Bruce Lee or someone else. But basically, the answer was, well, you put a line beside it that's longer. You lengthen your line. You know, instead of trying to cut down someone else, you lengthen your skills. You increase your skills. You lengthen your line. You become more intelligent. You learn more, and instead of cutting somebody out down, you can just increase your skill and improve your knowledge and things like that. There were other chapters, many other chapters in there. Know Your Limits. That was one of them. There's, you know, probably almost close to 30 stories in there, along with the sayings, like I said. But overall, Zen and the Martial Arts, it's a great book. It's inspirational. It's kind of thought-provoking on certain subjects, and it's not a book of techniques. If you're looking for techniques or how to do something physically like that, it's not a book. It's not, you know, a book on that. But great stories, influential people, and nowadays it's a good kind of historical reference and one of the best-selling martial arts books out there. Also, so. this Zen in the Martial Arts stands the test of time, and I'd recommend it to any of you out there. Check it out, and like, share, and subscribe to the channel here. We'll keep some more information coming out to you.